We've been together for about 12 years.
Yeah. Married.
It's our ninth anniversary next month.
Really?
Yeah.
Congrats.
Thanks. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Coincide with the marriage, though.
What's that?
You know what they say? Coincide with a union and a marriage.
What?
I'm going to go back to something Marshall did say. Well, you did say that he's steering a path. So people have it say, are you a Marshall mashup your singing career?
Oh, is that a thing?
Yeah.
If I remember correctly, so when it started off the interview, so the people them say, you mash up Tami Chin Curry.
Oh, yeah.
So they might ask you now, so make sure I say, it's not a lying thing.
It was him. He did it.
Yeah,
he said, you better
did
stop.
Did Wayne Marshall mash up your singing career?
Hold on, true and bread you?
True, he bred me. True, he bread and butter me. I could not sing no more.
Not like that. I'm here trying. I'm late, you know.
He's oh my God.
Well, no, man, I'm here trying to get her back into
dying,
singing.
But, you know, it's just, I mean, I don't even know. My thing did my shop. I didn't realize.
No,
I
because.
I just stopped. I don't know.
Because we were projecting you, or everybody was projecting you to be the next Rihanna because you signed with Akon and in the Frozen. Yeah. And you're going
and you
to
know,
be the
one day
prop sensation.
I woke up and I was like, I don't want to do this no more. But that's so me, right? Like, I just shifted course. Like,
really?
Can people have it say you got job, but you actually just walked away from the situation?
Twice, actually. Mm-hmm. Like, I was signed twice, and both times I was like, I don't think this is for me. And a lot of people don't realize what that world came with, and I just wasn't prepared to, you know.
Divulge. Tell us, because everybody, as you say, everybody wants a deal.
I mean, I don't even know what it's like now, to tell you the truth. But back then, I mean, it just came with a lot of sacrifice. And, you know, at that point in my life, I was done, like, kind of giving up so much of my time and myself. And, I mean, I just was done. And I wanted to be a mom. I wanted to be a wife. I wanted to be an entrepreneur. I wanted to be an author. I wanted to do all these other things. And I think people have a hard time wrapping their head around the fact that you can do more than one thing in your life. You know, they feel like if this is what you do, that's what you do.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm very lucky to come from a family that said, hey, if you want to do 10 things, let's figure out how to do the 10 things. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I mean, I was a kid who was like, I want to do this. And my mother never said, no, but you have to choose one.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So I think they call it like a multi-potentialite. Like they had to like dub it something.
Hyphenate.
Because there are people who are like that.
Yeah.
And even now, like, you know, I'm like.
Sorry.
That's when he used a big word. When he used a big word, he's.
What word did I use?
Multi-potentialite.
If that even is a word, I'm not even joking.
It's a made-up term.
Yeah.
They had to make it up for me.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just feel like there is not enough room for people to change their minds. And it's not for any like major bad reason. Like I just decided that wasn't the path
so
I
Akon
wanted to
Akon wasn't
go
a
on.
Good boss, is that?
He wasn't my boss.
Oh, but wasn't he like instrumental in signing at least the last
well,
time?
Well, you see, this is the thing. Like labor politics is so deep and it's how things look and blah, blah, blah. But I mean, you know. But he wasn't like an idiot or asshole guy. He was a great guy. Like, meaning I enjoyed work. Meaning when I did what I did, I enjoyed it.
Mm.
But the minute that I stopped being connected to it, I have to shift. Mm. You know, because that's just me. You know?
So was it something that said, I just don't want to do this anymore? Or it's just you just wake up really?
I just wanted to eat that donut. Wanted to have that burger. And I didn't want to be skinny anymore.
I admit that when you did the Frozen video, you were skinnier than from
I didn't even realize
from
how skinny
what
I was.
Yeah.
I mean, I go back sometimes and I'm like, oh my God.
So the label
like,
really had
the F?
Is that a real thing? Like them say like you have
no, the label didn't put me on a diet or anything, but and you know what's so funny about it? I did nyam, you know, really and truly. But it's stress, you know.
Mm.
Like, it was stress. It was stressful, like, you know, having to. And then you're living up to everybody else's expectations.
Mm.
And you forget what your own expectations are of your own self. So, you know, when people throw out things like, you know, the next Rihanna or right away, they're like, dude, I'm just me. Like, I don't come with these labels, expectations. I mean, anybody would tell you that's another thing about relationships. Like, drop your expectations or drop everybody else's expectations. Like, what do you want? And that's a hard thing to do sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
To then say, okay, what do I need to honor in myself?
Mm.
Like, what is important to me? It might not be what everybody wants, but I have to do what is right for me. And that's tough. And we need to actually help people to do that.
Wow.
And not do what, you know, they feel like they are supposed to do.
So Blow by Blow and every other project that he had, yeah, that was something that you wanted to
absolutely do. Okay. And let me tell you something, I will live my life that way for the rest of my life. I will be, you know, hopefully.
So you're not curious that you disappoint people, like, not to cut your words.
Who am I disappointing?
Really?
You have a legion of fans that, you know.
Yeah, but I still have so many people who follow my this true. New aspect of my life that's now. True. And people, you know, so, and I might sing again. Who knows? You know what I mean?
Because
I mean, she's born in a musical family, you know what I mean? Like sister, father, mother, everybody do music. So music is a part of her, I think. And music is a part of her journey. So I feel like when the right time comes. But I did fulfill
that part of my journey too. And like, I think a lot of people, including Wayne, have a hard time like really believing that. Especially Wayne, who is so, like, he loves music on a different level. Like, he is passionate. And I was there too, but I had a shift. So our personalities are different in that way. Like, my passions change.
Wow.
You know what I mean? And we're never taught that that's okay. You get told that you must be an idler, or lazy. But no, your passions absolutely change. You know what I mean? And
because
so,
look, even me, you know, me could I say.
Babe, why did you, I was making a good point.
Yeah, no, no, you but
stared
no,
it back to yourself.
Me! Overcome it!
You know what I'm asking? Nightly fix for Marge.
It's always somebody, right?
I rebuke you in the name of Jesus.
There you go. I said that all the time. I said that all the time.
Marshall.
Say for instance, me, you know, me could have said, boy, Jano star, you know, long me not sing a hit song, I go run the left it, but there's another school of thought where it's like, yo, keep knocking on the door, keep knocking, keep honing your craft, keep getting greater. You know what I mean? And then here it is now, I buck up on the biggest song of my career. Like, bar none, like, way.
You really feel so?
Yeah. Brother, I do an interview today with the guy who
did mean the biggest so far.
That's what I said to date. Oh, today, yeah, said that. Right. So, and it's after 18 years in the business. That's a big deal. You know what I mean? So you don't know. I'm here as a inspiration to other artists who are there now, feeling like, yo, Jano star.
And that happens a lot.
I'm gonna run taxi. I'm gonna do something. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, you can keep knocking and weary and then brighter days ahead. You get what I'm saying?
Because I guess the question goes to both, because, you know, well, mostly you, because the music change constantly, and I guess dance and I guess, but just like every other genre, looking for the new person, the new thing, the new star, I guess. So was it difficult? Like, you know, you said that it almost seemed like you were doing music, but it wasn't going to the masses.
Well, you know, as I said in the interview that I did, I was kind of just getting better, honing my craft, because I wanted to do bigger songs. Remember me telling
you? Yeah, it's like you took the downtime.
Exactly. Right. Because there's a time when you have to specialize in what you wanted, especially if you want to do it for a lifetime. Mm-hmm. You really have to zone in and do your masters and do your thing and go, you know what I mean? So I really had to spend time. That take time and effort. Yeah, and I can guarantee you, any of them artists here, we say them bad, we around the place, we have gift and talented. If them do pick up music and go down a music mark and pick up some book and pick up two instruments and go and try, knock and get lick. Them at them time that them are gonna kill people. Them time that them are gonna beat the road bad. I can guarantee you, it's not even a guess and spell. Because the truth is, in a place like Jamaica, anybody will rise above bad. Because every corner, every district, every lane have a bad artist in there. So for you make a name for yourself, boya, you have to be really tough.
And it's a lot of people, right?
Oh, you mean everybody want to be starring in Jamaica? Jamaica, this is just like New York of rapper. Jamaica of DJ, and artist, and singer.
And
you know what I
mean? 3 million away versus American.
Right.
100, yeah.
So you have to be really bad. And if you get a break, that means say you're bad. If you forgot and specialize and go deep in a music, and a man make music, you know, music bigger than the whole away. True. But it's a craft, it's a science within itself. So if you study and go deep, man, may I tell you, say, at them time that the world mash up. That Bob Marley them do, that Jimmy Cliff them do, that Peter Tosh do, that and any one of the greats them, Berries them, all of them can play instrument and do them
thing. I used to be like this, because I would just hear bang, bang, and I'd be like, oh, Jesus. And then, you know, eventually it'd be bang, bing, bong. And I was like, all right, we getting somewhere. And then I remember legit, like, you know, literally, I used to be like, babe, like, you know what? I'm going to have a baby so that you can just, so I can tell you it's nap time and so you can stop. No, but he stuck to it. And I've never seen somebody determined like Queen, yeah? Mm. Like, meaning... Me never seen nothing like it mm-hmm. in my life. I've never seen somebody, I mean, apart from like my father who plays music by ear, mm-hmm. actually teach themselves how to play an instrument. Like, that blows my mind. Even though I come from a musical family, mm-hmm. I mean, I've never had any interest in playing an instrument. But, you know, mm-hmm. I just watched him day after day and I was like, yo. And then one day I remember just like...
hearing something beautiful.
Like, oh my God, Wayne, play that YouTube again. And I came in and I was like, oh my God, it's you playing. Like, I couldn't believe it. I was like, oh Jesus. And then he picked up the guitar, so it started bang bang again. And then he did the drums and I was like, oh. But it proved to me that, like, and then I did see his music, like, become 100%. Mm-hmm. better mm-hmm. and I was like, damn,
isn't that special though, to see the progression and the growth of something.
It's not
something.
Always easy,
yeah,
you know, I mean, even as a partner, you know what I mean, like sometimes I mean I'm sure there are times where I was like, shut up, like, I'm sick of the pong pong.
And then it just goes a light on.
I used to do this. I'd be like, babe, play a chord for me. He'd be like, nah. No, babe, play a happy chord. How you feel about me? I only know minors, Tami. But, you know, it was, this is the other thing, like, you know, back to even that point, like, you know, every artist and every person goes through, you know, your peaks and your valleys, and people always underestimate or even want to, like, torture you when you're going through your valley, right? But like, that's where you collect, especially as a musician, that's where you collect your material. Mm. That's where you write the songs. That's where you collect the experiences to go back up to the peak. You know what I mean? So I'm always like, you know, I feel I'm always like, you know, it happens even with Tessie. People are like, what's happening with Tessie? And I'm like, yo, can you honor the valley? Like, because when the peak returns, it's because of that visit there and that time there that can collect you, and it's true for all of our lives.
Yeah,
you know, so I'm always
you just give
people,
a word.
Yeah, thank you, girl.
Preach.
Come on now, find up for that. But the truth is, y'all got this shit wrong. That's not just true for artists, that's true for everybody. And right. You know, I mean, all of us do need to honor the valleys. Mm-hmm. We do, because
I don't think that's our culture.
No, or, but it's nobody's culture. Everybody wants, and when you're down there, everybody's like, oh, has she been down there a while? Mm-hmm.
And she hear them not. Hear them when them
and
see
when
them.
They come back up, I knew hear it.
Yo, Marshall, you stop sing.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, dog, we just put out a song last week.
Yeah, we kid.
But was that supposed to motivate me? No, it was supposed to drop you into a deep hole.
Yeah, you have to be aware of that.
Yeah, you have to be aware of how them come at you. Mm-hmm. You see me?
And you have to be aware of the listening man. That too, yeah.
Yeah, it's just like people will say, boy, you get fatty. You know, like, you know, when them see a girl and say, you get fatty, they know what they're doing.
About me.
Because you're a big person, you know, say people don't really like them type of, you know what I mean? Yeah. Them know, say, you're going to mash up this girl day, you know, with that comment there.
They didn't
like,
mash up my day.
I said another time, like, I have a mirror. I know what I look like. I have a mirror. Yeah.
Tell me, Chin, insecurities are.
Zoom in. In fact.
You're at me.
Okay, I look really good in the dark. Okay.
No, you should have said one more time.
He got distracted thinking about me in the dark. Yeah, Naro, we know.
Awkward.
So that's where you are right now in your musical journey. You feel like you're at a
that's valley just where
space
I'm in my journey. I'm not in a valley space. I'm just in my journey. You know?
Not even musical.
And it's not. It's just where I am. Like, I'm 35 years old. I remember when I thought it would be like a crime to. Dude, I go on Instagram with like the worst filters because I'm like, if I see another flower crown, I'm going to shoot myself. Or another pair of bunny ears.
Right.
So I use the snap filters mm-hmm. too. But, you know.
Tami uses the worst
one. I do because they're the funniest to me. You know? That's what inspires me. Like, that's what's funny. But I just think it's time that we, you know, we're just okay. You know, like, I'm never going to be 25 again. Mm. Like, that's a fact of life. And thank God. But, I mean, like I said, even just saying, like, my age a while ago, like, and you're like, you actually stated that. Yeah. Like, dude, we're, like, why wouldn't I? Like, we're on this journey. And
I guess because she looked good for 35.
No, some people would say, I'm actually 45. I'm gonna start doing that.
Wait, so talk about that too, because you said that you don't want to be 25.
I don't want to be 25 again.
What lessons have you learned between that time?
25 was insecure. 25 wasn't sure. 25 was like, what's gonna happen? Da, 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 da. And 35 is like, no, really sure that everything always works out.
Mm.
All of that worry was worth
nothing.
I don't want to I'm swear again. I'm
literally at that place now.
How old are you?
25.
All right, yeah. Everything you think that is like, trust me, it's all like shit. Like, don't even worry about it. And if I could, and this is something that like I practice doing, like if I could tell my 25-year-old something, self something, it would be, yo, you are okay.
When you learned that though,
yeah.
Was it this year?
Girl, I learned it just a minute ago. I learned it along the way. And yeah. Every stage, every year you get older, you'll be like, oh, yeah, 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 yeah. So nice to not worry about that. So nice to know that's not important. For real. Like, I've heard it, but so nice to know it. You know what I mean?
Because that's what everybody say. Like, I mean...
And men don't go through this nearly as much as women do, because we're so shamed in aging and getting older and blah, blah, blah. Yeah. I mean, a man, you know? It doesn't matter. Like, even in the industry, like, men can go on for however they're long distinguished. To do.
When they're older, they're distinguished. And we're like nearly old as hags. Many
women, you know, touring as long. And I think we're going to see a change in that, you know? But also, I think that has a lot to do with the fact that our passions change.
Yeah.
You know? And there's this myth that, and I think that's why, for me, it was like, you know, why I stopped singing was because I got pregnant. Like, women can be pregnant and have a career, like Cardi in anything, Cardi, and they do. You know, not just Cardi B.
Cardi B ready back?
But even our local artists here, true. So many women who still have babies Spice. And still do the damn thing.
Yeah. Spice around the place. I mean,
come on, true. You know. So that's like, no, that's not why. You know, and if I wanted to pick up and sing tomorrow, I would, but it's just not where I am.
Win was the same question, like 25 versus how old are you now? 38. Like, what you know at 28 versus 38,
you know? Yo, so many lessons over the years. Wow. To me, it's a lot more like it don't feel so separate, you know what I mean? Because basically, I'm still doing the same thing, still doing the music, still trying to, you know, be a better artist, be a greater man, you know what I mean? I don't know. It's Super Soul Sunday.
I thought you're always spiritual.
No, because I don't want to go back to spiritual, and we're done past that already. You know what I mean? It's just all about growth for me. You know what I mean? It's all about growth.
So you were never a warrior? Like, you never worry about nothing?
No. When we're 25.
Yeah.
We are hot boy, I rode with us. I go party to party and I do songs and I do music. Me and Elephant, them a par. You know what I mean? Me and Bunty, me and Cartel, them Sasko, you know? So it's really just evolving and growing as a man. Like, I can't really look back at that man and say, boy, what we learn from. You know what I mean? We just grow and we evolve, and now I'm at a different stage. You know what I mean? Appreciating different things.
And that's such a lesson, because men don't look back nearly as much as women. And so we as women live a lot either in the past or in the future.
Never know.
I think men live way more future and present than we do. And that's a real lesson too. You know what I mean? Like, you heard the big difference in our answers. You know what I mean? And that is just the truth. Like, for us anyway. Yeah. At 25, I was just, a stress ball. And at 35, I'm learning to detangle all of that and unpack all of that. You know what I mean? But truth is this.
It gets better.
Does it? I don't know. I mean, you get better. You know? I don't think that anything necessarily changes. You just change. You change. You get better.